This is gonna be the toughest exam I've ever had in my life.
Like, that's a good thing?
To have a professor really test you. Oh, I'm so jazzed I dropped archaeology for this. That's just bones, but psychology.
Hey, it's bad enough I gotta look at it, but in front of company?
Aren't you gonna introduce us?
We're studying here.
Who's stopping you?
Plum, Polly, Polly, Plum.
How you doing, Plum?
Hey. Okay, what were you saying?
What's up with this door?
Just kick it. Oh, my God, are you an animal?
Like she hasn't seen one.
Yeah, good. Just stand there blowing in the breeze. I am so sorry.
It's okay.
You know what? We're going to go to school and study. Come on, Plum. You're such a pig. I'm telling Ma.
What?
But that engagement ring he bought you is nuts.
I like it.
I know. I got nothing against the ring itself. But if you're wearing clothes or an apron or something, then all these mooks here are not going to know you're taken.
Don't worry. They know that I'm taken.
Plum. Come here. I'm going to tell you something.
Yeah.
Last year, I saw something that no parent wants to see. His son with a broken heart. I thought Polly was down for the count. I really did. But then he met you. Now, I didn't know he met you. But he was walking around with this stupid grin on his face and his twinkle in his eye. Goofy, you know? And you started coming around, and I put two and two together.
Thank you, Mr. DeLuca.
Yeah. My boy loves you very much.
And I love him very much.
Well, that's rare. That's beautiful. So it works out. Listen, don't worry about Mrs. DeLuca. She's got a soft spot in her heart for Polly, and he can talk her into anything.
Will you pick a weekend?
Well, anyone's fine with me.
Polly!
No one's home.
Will you concentrate, please? This is your wedding, too.
Columbus Day, I'm Italian.
I have midterms. I can't. Stop it.
It slipped.
Ooh, Halloween. Yeah, we can, like, wear costumes and we can rent a fog machine.
I have to work.
How do you know?
Cops always work on Halloween. It's annual Loonies night.
And Thanksgiving weekend.
Perfect. Well, now that we got that settled.
You can tell your mother.
You better hang out to the license. Mom goes through everything. I don't want to find it beforehand.
Okay, what are you going to tell your parents?
That I'm taking a vacation day, driving to Atlantic City for the comic book convention.
Okay, but I'm scheduled to work at the Cucina.
Who said you have an appointment?
What if your dad asks what kind of appointment?
Tell him you're getting a tattoo removed. He'll give you the whole week off.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
How'd you like it? Hi.
Hey. How are you guys? Did you have a nice day?
Yeah, great. No problems to speak of.
Yeah, nothing special. A pretty ordinary day, really.
What kept you out so late?
Research.
Traffic.
Lincoln Tunnel.
You went to New York?
No.
Oh. Well, how'd you get stuck in Lincoln Tunnel traffic when you're on this side of the Lincoln Tunnel?
Big spillover. You don't want to even know. You want to go watch that game I taped?
You know, I got to get back to the dorm. I got a lot of work.
25% for your term paper and 30% for your community service work. But please note, community service is not an option. Yes?
Any chance of one of these community service jobs paying a salary?
If it paid a salary, it wouldn't be community service.
How do they expect me to be a full-time student, hold down a full-time job, and fit in community service?
Not like I have a full-time job right now, which I need to get, like, yesterday if I'm going to pay my rent.
Hey, what about this? Campus watch. We could get to carry walkie-talkies. We could do the whole Charlie's Angels thing. What do you think?
No, thanks. I get enough of the cops with my brother. I'm going to check the board.
Hey, Polly isn't involved in this, is he? Because, you know, it's kind of weird when, like, you hook up with someone for the first time and then you see him again and it's all like, bleh.
Please, Polly doing community service? He acts put upon when you ask him to scrape his plate.
Oh, here's something.
Kids at a rec center. Cool.
Why don't we give him... We'll give him every other Wednesday.
Wednesday?
Right, and then we'll just take Hanson off of... No, if we take him off of Saturday, then that leaves us with no backup.
I thought you were my sister.
Surprise.
Yeah, nice surprise. Mm-hmm. You know, it's kind of wonderful having you right upstairs.
Your parents are 2 feet away.
Oh, don't worry about them. They sleep like rocks. Mm-hmm. Mm. Come on downstairs.
Okay. Oh, I forgot something in my bag.
Hey. You're not coming back out, are you?
You are so easy. Good night, you.
Good night, you.
Yawn. You have to go out with him. It's gonna be the most exciting thing to happen to me all semester. Thing is, he's exactly like the kind of guys I always wanted to date and never did, you know? That creative, sensitive, musician, bohemian type, you know, with intense eyes and hair as long as mine.
Yeah. Okay, two worst case scenarios. One, you go out with him and then you totally regret it the next day. Or two, you don't go out with him and you regret it till you're 90. Go out with him. Do it.
Really?
Do it.
On this. You know, half these kids, they pull an all-nighter and they toss it in the pot. I've got footnotes.
Life is unfair. Maybe you pissed him off. Myth and metaphor and Shakespeare's tragedies. That, like, this is everything that he is about.
So what? I'm not allowed to challenge him? It only goes one way?
Lydia, hi.
Oh, Dean Norman.
Oh, Pamela, please. So, how is my favorite freshman?
Okay.
I detect something less than okay.
It's crappy, less than okay.
A C, Lydia.
Look, this is one great paper. I worked my butt off on this. This Professor Cahill is a real problem.
Let me tell you a little secret about Jeff Cahill. He likes being challenged. So if it's truly a good paper, get in his face. Make a case. He'll do something about it. And tell him that the Dean of Students says hi.
Thanks. Hey, it's like 40 degrees.
It wasn't a date, right?
A total non-event.
Okay, so why can't you just let it go?
Because she accused me.
You know, if it's gonna eat away at your liver, then go tell Cahill to march on over to the Queen's office. You know, give her the 411 on how you are a non-issue.
No, I'm not dragging him into this.
You already dragged him.
It wasn't a date.
Hey, I like you, and I don't believe you. I mean, if you make an enemy out of a professor, it could be a very long semester. Have you considered, a big ol' ass-kissing apology?
Apologize for what? I'm right.
So then how come you have to do your whole paper over? He's getting away.
You're gonna look so great in that dress.
Beato lui fra le donne belle.
Fred, what?
It's something that Grandpa Renzi used to say all the time. Beato lui fra le donne belle. Blessed is he who is surrounded by beautiful women. I already have two beautiful women in my family, and in 2 weeks, we're gonna have another one.
Thank you, Mr. D. Hey, and in 2 weeks, you will officially become my sister. Cool.
In 2 weeks, I'll never be able to get everything done that needs to be done.
Dollface, all you have to do is tell us how we can help.
Honey, it would take longer to explain to you how to do it right than to just do it myself.
Actually, you know, I have something for you to do, Mr. D.
Name it.
Since, you know, my parents are boycotting, I don't have anyone to walk me down the aisle.
I would be honored.
Me too. Thank you.
Hey, Mom, what's for eats?
Holy, get out of here! Turn around, quick!
You're supposed to be at work.
Well, I was on break. I was hungry.
Everybody knows you're not supposed to see the bride in her dress before the ceremony. It's bad luck.
Ah, that's an old wives' tale.
Yeah, well, this old wife is telling you no good is gonna come of this.
We're both kind of impulsive people, so when we met, it was like, bam.
We could hardly keep our hands off each other. Then the next few months were like a blur.
And when we, like, finally came up for air...
After we secretly eloped...
We realized you're exactly how different we really are.
Like, she thinks it's perfectly okay for her to hang out with the Rex boyfriend.
And he thinks that it's 1954.
So what we're saying is...
We made a big mistake.
And we want a divorce.
Hey, there he is. Hey, Alan, wait!
Oh, thank God!
Hey. What are you doing? You changed your mind?
Yeah, we're staying married. Oh, thanks.
This is awful hasty. I don't want to see you two making a mistake.
No, we're not making a mistake.
Don't sound so disappointed. Fork over those divorce papers.
Getting you this divorce was my vacation, you know.
Oh, come on.
All right.
Come on.
Take the ticket, too. It's refundable. See? Not such a bad guy.
Thanks. Keep the retainer. It's the least we can do.
Back to the office.
Did you eat yet?
I could eat.
Mrs. DeLuca?
Yes, Mr. DeLuca.
Have I told you lately how much I dig this marriage thing?
And what part of this marriage thing do you dig the most?
Yes.
Oh, sorry.
Where? I'm in here.
The door wasn't locked.
The lock's broken, Mom. I thought this was supposed to be our bathroom now.
I just wanted to get some rubbing alcohol. Next time, crack that window open so we don't get mildew in here.
Frank, I thought you fixed this door.
I'm sorry, baby.
I fixed it already. What's the matter with it now?
Oh. Hey, I'm in here.
I'm sorry, son.
One sec.
Yeah, it's sticking. I'll get my $2.
Hey, how much longer are you going to hold Victor?
Until my arms fall off. I have godmother rights.
I just can't get over this little fingernail.
It's so much fun having the little baby in the house again.
Hey, I was next.
Yeah, as opposed to our big baby.
I can't believe all the work you're putting into that. I mean, Victor's only going to wear that christening gown once.
Well, maybe you'll pass it on to Lydia when she needs it. The fabric hasn't disintegrated by then.
All right, let's just concern ourselves with the christening of the baby that actually exists.
Hey, Jack, have you picked out a middle name for him yet?
No, I can't decide.
Don't give him one. It's not a law.
No, he should have a middle name to fall back on in case he hates his first name.
You should have a saint's name, you know.
I like to know the name of the saint that knocked up my mother.
Why?
So I don't name the baby that by accident.
God forbid.
You don't know your father's name?
Yeah, well, his business card reads, jerk who got a 15-year-old pregnant, then left her high and dry.
My mother hasn't been dry ever since then.
What kind of father walks out on his kid?
The kind you're better off not knowing.
I just want to name my son right. Let me have him. Oh, come here.
I'm working on my master's.
At MSU?
Yeah.
Get out! But you're not in this class.
No, I have some undergraduate credits to fulfill, but this isn't one of them, no. I'm the teaching assistant for the course.
Shut up.
Yeah, it's not gonna be a problem, is it?
Why would it be a problem?
I don't know. I just hope it doesn't bother your husband.
Why, because you're my ex-boyfriend? Are you kidding me? Polly's way beyond that stuff.
Are you sure, Plum? Last time I was in town, he almost put me in jail for rolling through a stop sign at 2 miles an hour.
If he pulled you over and gave you a ticket, it's because you deserved it. This is so not a big deal. My husband is more mature than you're giving him credit for.
Great. Description right here.
Hi, baby.
Hey, baby. Chocolate cake? What's the occasion?
No occasion. I saw in the bakery and it seemed to call out your name.
Everything okay?
Oh, yeah, everything's fine. I just wanted to do something nice for my sexy guy.
Go ahead.
Let's fill out the paperwork first. Write everything.
Stella?
Every single thing.
Stella, I'm sorry, okay?
You'll get yours, Jack.
Come on, Stella, maybe let's just go home.
Hey, Jack.
What's that about?
Domestic dispute. I just want to talk to Stella.
Later. Wait there. Thank you.
Speaking of that, before ours gets out of hand, I want you to know that I'm dropping Gavin's class.
Baby, wait right here. Jack, can I get you a cup of coffee?
No, I don't want coffee. I just want to talk to Stella.
Well, you might want to wait outside. We got a bunch of chairs.
No, I'm okay. Keep your hands off.
He's got a gun in his belt.
I got a partner.
I can't believe you. You are a freaking moron.
This your idea of conversation, Jack?
You got it?
Yeah.
Come on.
I hope they lock you up and they lose the key.
Shut your mouth.
You're going to make me.
Baby, I got a bunch of paperwork to do. I'll see you back at the house, okay?
Nice job, Polly. Natural born cop.
It's a crime he doesn't take that sergeant exam.
I know, I was surprised he changed his mind.
Yeah, he just got down on himself after he choked on a practice test.
He choked?
Yeah, he crashed and burned.
Vegetables, we moved out to better things.
We're roasting marshmallows.
Dollface, look at that fire, it's perfect.
We got one for you if you want.
Great.
If she wants, she set the DeLuca family record.
That's right. All right.